Our circulatory system is made up of blood vessels that transport blood to and from the heart throughout the body. The heart and lungs work together to pump oxygenated blood through arteries to all of our organs, tissues, and cells. Once oxygen molecules are delivered, then deoxygenated blood is transported back to the heart through veins, where it is pumped back through the lungs to pick up new oxygen molecules. This is a simplified explanation of the phenomenon known as circulation. With that said, whenever there is poor circulation in the body, it can result in a number of different unwanted signs and symptoms. And that is exactly what we are going to discuss in this video. Keep in mind that poor circulation is not considered to be a condition in itself. It happens as a result of a separate health issue. That is why it's important to be aware of some of the common symptoms that we are going to share in this video. Be sure to watch until the end because there's one that I think will surprise you. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. The first symptom that I want to mention is the uncomfortable feeling of numbness and tingling. Have you ever laid on your arm while sleeping and woke up feeling like you are unable to move it? Not only could you not move your arm, but you also may have felt like someone was poking it with pins and needles. That is exactly what this feeling of numbness and tingling that I'm referring to feels like. The difference is that when it is caused by low blood flow to the area, you will feel this even without lying down or placing any pressure on that arm or leg. If the feeling of numbness and tingling is caused by poor blood circulation, you may begin to feel it starting at the tips of your fingers and toes. Swelling is another sign of poor blood circulation that you should definitely be aware of. In its simplest form, the meaning of swelling is a collection of fluid in your body's tissues. Medical terminology coins this symptom as edema. Edema caused by poor circulation can show up in your feet and ankles, as well as other places in the body, such as the fingers and hands. This type of swelling causes major discomfort when standing or sitting for too long and is not caused by anything visibly obvious, such as cuts, bites, or other wounds. The next sign to look for is fatigue. Do you ever feel like, no matter how much sleep you get at night, you're still extremely tired during the day? No amount of coffee or other caffeinated beverage can help you gain the energy that you need. Well, fatigue, coupled with other symptoms included in this video, can be a sign of poor blood circulation. In general, red blood cells use hemoglobin to transport oxygen throughout the body. This means that normal levels of hemoglobin are needed in order to provide an adequate amount of oxygen to our muscles, tissues, brain, and heart. When there is a disruption in blood flow, it tends to lower the amount of oxygen that we receive, which can lead to the feelings of fatigue that you may be experiencing. Muscle cramps are another sign to be aware of. As your blood circulates throughout the body, it drops off many important minerals and nutrients to your muscles. Therefore, poor blood circulation to your muscles affects how they respond to physical activity. Electrolytes are very important factors in muscle movement. So if you have low levels due to poor blood circulation, it can lead to increased muscle cramping, which can be quite unpleasant. The next sign that we need to talk about is hair loss. This is often surprising to most people because you typically wouldn't associate losing strands of hair with poor blood circulation. However, whenever there is low blood flow to the skin of your scalp, the hair follicles are not getting the nutrients needed for proper hair growth and strength. Over time, your hair strands become brittle and dull, which explains why it can break or fall out much easier. A weakened immune system is yet another symptom that is often surprising to most people. Our immune system is the first line defense against foreign invaders such as viruses, bacteria, and toxins. One of the most important components of this system is white blood cells, which are transported in blood during circulation. So if your body has poor circulation, fewer white blood cells are available to fight off infections, which leaves you with a weakened immune system and a greater likelihood of getting sick. The next symptom on our list is cold hands and feet. During the winter months, this may seem completely normal. However, if you still have cold hands and feet even after warming up, this could be a sign of poor circulation in your body. In general, the blood in your body tends to be warm whenever there is normal perfusion to your extremities. So whenever there is low blood flow to those areas, this explains why your fingers and toes may be cold or cool to touch. And we couldn't have made this video without including the next sign, which is varicose veins. In order to understand varicose veins, let's talk a little about how veins normally work. Veins are basically one-way streets of blood flow. The blood that rushes through them is helped along by valves and the movement of the tissue surrounding the veins. When these valves become weak or damaged, the blood in the veins tends to pool and in turn makes the vein more visible on the surface of your skin. Varicose veins are also known as spider veins because the connections look similar to a spider web when visible. These veins also have the potential to grow larger and bulge beyond the skin's surface. Because the valves in the veins are damaged, this causes poor blood circulation to that area, causing varicose veins to show through your skin. Switching gears just a bit, erectile dysfunction is another sign that we need to discuss. ED is typically more prevalent as men get older. However, this isn't always the case. Whenever ED is present, it is due to a lack of blood flow to that area. This topic may not be the most comfortable to talk about, but it is important to bring this up with your primary care physician. That is because poor blood circulation to that area may be a sign of an underlying health issue such as heart disease, atherosclerosis, or diabetes. The next sign that you need to know about is skin discoloration. Whenever there is good blood flow to your skin, it will have the normal color that we're all accustomed to. However, if you have poor circulation, your skin may show signs of discoloration. For example, a lack of blood circulation throughout the body means that your cells and tissues are not getting enough oxygen. This leads to a pale or bluish discoloration of your skin, which is referred to as cyanosis. You may also notice a change in color in your lips, fingers, or toes as well. So just to give a quick recap, the signs and symptoms of poor blood circulation to look for include numbness and tingling, swelling, fatigue, muscle cramps, hair loss, a weakened immune system, cold hands and feet, varicose veins, erectile dysfunction, and skin discoloration. Real quick guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Millions of people around the world are looking for ways to improve circulation and boost the health of their cardiovascular system. Hopefully, the information that you learned in this video can help you do just that. With that said, keep in mind that we are not doctors and this video should not be taken as medical advice. Again, this video is for informational purposes only. But hopefully you learned a thing or two and hopefully you're now one step closer to improving your overall health and thus improving the overall quality of your life. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to learn even more about this topic, we do have a full guide on our website. I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.